episode of Swiss Cheese and Beats. My name is Daniel Asghari, and I'm creating this channel to help anybody interested in learning a little bit more about marching percussion. I see a lot of videos from the students I have, these great, incredible players with crazy hands, but I'm really interested in helping you guys learn how to develop the skills in order to play those things. So today, we're gonna talk about something super critical. I think it gets overlooked at all levels. The fulcrum. It's going to be compromised with your thumb and your index finger. And together, what's going to happen is those two fingers are going to come together nicely to create a pivot point for the stick in order for the stick to have the proper range of motion for you to play correctly. Some of the things that I'll often see, especially in younger players, is their fulcrum will constantly be moving around. And that is either they'll have their thumb way up on the stick like this, or their index finger will be hanging off like so. A big mistake that I often see in a lot of even advanced players is they'll let their fulcrum open up. And what I mean by that is they'll allow a space between their thumb and their index finger to open up right there into their hand. All that does is move the fulcrum to the back of the hand. And by moving your fulcrum to the back of the hand, you take away the pivot point of the stick. I'm gonna walk you through step by step exactly how to create the proper fulcrum, and you wanna make sure that you're keeping an eye on it when you practice. So the very first thing is you have a thumb, right? You have a thumbprint. That thumbprint needs to be on the stick at all times. I see a lot of players take their thumb, and you can see their thumb kinda hanging off this way. Even some of them come this way. You wanna make sure that that thumbprint is right on the stick. The other finger that's involved is your index finger, right? Like I said earlier, a lot of people take their index finger and they let their index finger hang off. Again, you're moving the fulcrum to the back of the hand, and that's not what you want. So you wanna take your index finger and you wanna wrap your index finger around the stick. You're gonna feel your actual fingerprint of your index finger make contact with the stick. Now, this is gonna be a little different if you're playing with, let's say, smaller, thinner sticks like drum set sticks, right? For me, if I wrap my finger all the way around the stick, I'm almost gonna feel like I'm choking it off, like the stick is getting moved to the back of my index finger, and that's not what I want either. So you have to be very careful when it comes to, well, not only your hand size, but what type of stick you're playing with. Obviously, with drum set sticks, you know, technique, there's so many different techniques and approaches when it comes to drum set. What I'm specifically talking about is rudimental drumming, and with that, you probably want to use a larger stick. You want to wrap your index finger around the stick. A good way to make sure and check that your fulcrum is correct is you want to look for two things. One, you want to make sure your thumb and your index finger are in a line. So as you can see here, if I were to draw a straight line going across, that line would go directly through my thumb, through the stick, through my index finger. You do not want it to be like so or like so. If you do either one of those, again, you're moving the fulcrum to the back of the hand. Try to keep these two fingers, your thumb and index finger, directly in line. Second thing you want to look at. When you bring your stick down to play, there should not be an opening here in the fulcrum. If you see an opening like this, you want to tuck the stick in a little bit closer to your index finger, and that's going to create a nice seal right there. You should be able to take your back three fingers off the stick, still have that same seal, and it shouldn't affect anything. So this is what it's going to look like here. Again, double check, thumbprint on the stick, index finger wrapped around the stick, create the seal, and that is your proper fulcrum for match grip. Traditional grip, obviously a little different because we're using a different type of grip. So, same fingers create the traditional grip fulcrum, thumb, index finger. You can kind of see this is kind of an okay sign, but if you look here, what I'm doing is I'm taking this line that goes across between my first knuckle and my thumb, and again here between my first and second knuckle of my index finger, and I'm gonna try to bring those together, and it's gonna create this teardrop shape. And you create that same shape with that left hand. What's gonna happen is you create, again, a seal around the stick. I see a lot of people, when the traditional grip, they'll either have these two fingers completely apart, which you can't really control much of anything, especially as you get into the more advanced rudiments, or I'll often see a lot of people have space here. Sometimes they bring their fingertips together, their thumb tip and their index finger together like that, and trying to create a fulcrum that way, it's not gonna work. In fact, your fulcrum muscles are gonna be in this spot right here, this pocket between your index finger and your thumb. Most everybody should be able to do this. If you put the stick right here in between your thumb and your index finger, then the stick should be able to hang there properly like this. In fact, if you're able to rotate like this and keep the stick level, you're probably gonna feel a little bit of tension, but those are the muscles you're gonna be using when it comes to squeezing and releasing the fulcrum, something we'll talk about later on. A good way to check your fulcrum, is go ahead and put the stick right there in between your index finger and your thumb. Take your right hand and go ahead and just use your index finger or your hand to hold the stick up. That way you're not squeezing, you're not trying to create any tension to hold the stick up. So you're holding it up here, you take your thumb. Again, you're gonna wrap your index finger around the stick, and then you're gonna bring this line separating your thumb pad and the rest of your thumb, and bring it into contact with the line here separating your first and your second knuckle of your index finger, creating again a nice seal right there. That's gonna be your fulcrum for your left hand. Again, the right hand, you have your right hand fulcrum, left hand fulcrum, traditional grip. Nice level, good solid triangle here, right in the center of the drum. If you're playing match grip, you want to check and make sure that your fulcrums and your sticks are exactly the same. The way to do that, whatever your strong hand is, find your fulcrum there. I'm right-handed, so I'm going to get my fulcrum set here, and then I'm going to make sure that my left feels and looks exactly the same as my right. And a good way to check that is you want to line up your thumbs and the beads of the stick. Sometimes you'll see beads of the sticks lined up, but if you look here, my thumbs, right? My thumbs aren't in line at all. Or my thumbs will be in line, but the beads of the sticks are not. So again, you wanna make sure that your thumbs and the beads of the sticks are in line, create that nice triangle, nice and relaxed. And to keep an eye, whenever you play, you wanna make sure you keep an eye on those fulcrums, make sure everything's nice and solid. If you have any questions, you have any comments, there's something that maybe you need help with, please leave me a comment below. Also follow me on Instagram, you can leave a comment there, maybe something you want me to put in the next video, or I also have a link on there where you can send me an email if you have a question you would feel more comfortable sending that way. Thank you so much for tuning in, I'll see you next time.
Hip hop is the basis of like a lot of forms of music, because that music is like salvation, whether it's to perform it or to listen to it. It's a safety valve for society, because without that, there would be chaos.